Okay, so let's recall that if you take 2 and you multiply it by x plus 3, well, what you do with the 2 is you distribute that. So the 2 gets multiplied by the x, and the 2 also gets multiplied by the 3, and you get, as you know, 2x plus 6. Now, when you multiply, you take a product, so this is a product here, and you end up with a sum. Now, the question we're going to ask ourselves in this video is it possible to go the other way? Can you start off with a sum and write it as a product? That is, how are we going to be able to begin with 2x plus 6 and write that as 2 multiplied by x plus 3? How do we do that? And the answer is we begin with starting what's called factoring out the GCF. So let's see an example of how this works. So we're going to factor out the GCF. Okay. So let's say that we had the following sum. Let's say that we had 6x cubed minus 15x squared. Okay, so what we do is we begin by finding the GCF of these two terms. So like we did in the previous video, we ask ourselves, well, let's start with the 6 and the 15. What's the GCF of 6 and 15? That would be 3. And then I move on to their variable parts, right? The x cubed and the x squared. And how many x's do they have in common? That would be 2. Now, once you've identified the GCF, then what you do is you write in parentheses like so. And here's the new idea. What we're doing is we're going from a difference to a product. Now, this is multiplication right here, and what I'm going to put in parentheses, I'm going to fill in the parentheses in a way that accounts for the fact that the 3x squared is going to be distributed. So here's what I say to myself. 3x squared times what will give me 6x cubed? Well, 3 times what, first of all, gives 6? That would be 2. And then x squared times what will give me x cubed? That will be x. So let's just check that. 3x squared multiplied by 2x is 6x cubed. And then minus, well, now we go on to the next one. 3 times what will give 15? That's going to be a 5. And then x squared times what gives x squared? Well, I don't need anything else here, right? Because 3x squared multiplied by 5 gives me my 15x squared. So at this stage, notice how I went from a sum to a product. And what's on the outside right here? That's the GCF. So what I've done is I've what we call factored out the GCF. And you check, once you have the GCF, you fill in what's inside the parentheses as if you were distributing the 3x squared. That's how you determine what goes here. So this is my answer. I've simply factored out the GCF. Okay, let's try another one like that. Okay, let's factor out the GCF. Okay, let's say that we had something a little longer. Let's say that we had 21x squared y cubed minus 15xy squared plus 24x squared y squared. Okay, so we're going to use the same logic that we used in the previous example. And the first thing we do is identify the GCF. So I start with the coefficients, 21, 15, and 24. Do you see the largest number that goes evenly into those? That would be a 3. And then I move on to the x's. Well, 2x's, 1x, and 2x's, how many do they have in common? That is, how many do they all individually have? Well, everybody has at least one x. That's what they have in common. And how many y's do they have in common? Well, 3 y's here, 2 y's there, and 2 y's. So in common, they have 2 y's. Once you have the GCF, what you do is you create parentheses and you think about distribution. So this, that is your GCF multiplied by what, will first give me my first term right here. Well, 3 times what will give me the 21? That's got to be a 7. And now x times what will give me x squared? Well, I need one more x. And y squared times what will give me y cubed? I need another y. And I move on to the next one. 3 times what will give me negative 15? Well, that'll be a negative 5. And let's see, x, well, when I distribute that x, the x shows up here, but this only needs one x. So I don't want to put any x's in here because the only x that I need is already supplied by the GCF. How many y's do I need? Well, y squared times the 5, the y squared will be here, but I only need 2 y's, so I wouldn't put in an x or a y. We move on to the next one. What would I need here? Well, 3 times what will give me 24? That'll be 8. Do I need any x's? Let me see. X times what? Well, if I have to get up to x squared, clearly I need one more x, because this only supplies one x, right? So x times x is how I'm going to get x squared. Do I need any y's here? Well, let's see. Y squared will appear right there upon distribution, and I only need to get to y squared. So no y's are necessary right there. So I'm finished at this stage. I've managed to write this as a product with the GCF factored out. And that's how we factor out the GCF. Now there's one more situation that we should talk about that often arises in applications. So let's say that you were asked to factor. Once again, you were asked to factor out the GCF, but let's say that your, what we call your leading coefficient, that is the first coefficient, let's say that was negative. So let's say that you had negative 4x cubed plus 6x squared. Do you see how the lead coefficient is negative? So I have a negative 4 here. When that happens, we often factor out the negative as well. So I'm going to factor out the GCF, but I'm going to include a negative being factored out. So then I move on and say, okay, well, what do the 4 and the 6 have in common? That would be a 2. And x cubed and x squared, once again, I'm going to factor out an x squared. So the difference is that not only do we have the GCF, we also have the negative, and I did that because the lead coefficient was negative. Okay, so upon distribution, what do I get? Well, this times what will give me that? Do you see why it has to be a positive 2x? Well, a negative 2 times a positive 2 will give me negative 4, and x squared times x will give me x cubed. Okay, now the fun part of this problem. Remember, you're distributing the negative 2x squared, and you're trying to get to a positive 6x squared. So should this be positive or negative? Well, you're trying to get to a positive, and you're multiplying by a negative, so this has to be a negative. Well, a negative what? A negative 3. Why? Because a negative 2 times a negative 3, that's how you're going to get the positive 6. And now I ask myself, do I need any x's? Well, let's see, x squared, upon distribution, it shows up right here, and this already has 2x, this only has 2x's, rather. So I don't have to put any x's in here. And I'm finished. So at this stage, I factored out my GCF with a negative factored out as well. And that's our first technique of factoring out the GCF.